how secure is Linux really? If you're using a standard distribution such as Fedora, Debian, or Arch Linux, you probably think you have great security. While desktop Linux is still a viable option, it currently falls significantly behind alternatives like macOS and Android in several areas. Secure boot on Linux is not as robust as alternatives such as Apple's Secure Boot or Android's Verified Boot. Secure boot prevents persistent tampering by malware and evil-made attacks. While it is present on some Linux distributions, it doesn't offer the same level of protection compared to Windows or macOS. Strong sandboxing for apps on Linux is severely lacking, even with package formats like Flatpaks or sandboxing solutions like Firejail. Flatpak integrates Bubble Wrap, which is the most promising sandboxing utility for Linux thus far, but is still deficient in many areas and allows for unsafe defaults, which permit most apps to trivially bypass its sandbox. While it's true that Linux could improve its support for secure boot and sandboxing, it's important to remember that the Linux desktop has never had a strong focus on security. In fact, the security landscape for desktop Linux is characterized by numerous fundamental issues. We hope to see improvements in these areas in the future. However, for someone whose top priority is security, they shouldn't be using desktop Linux. This isn't to say you shouldn't use it. Security is just one aspect of your computer system. Proprietary operating systems have invasive telemetry and data collection, which make them a bad choice if you're concerned about privacy. While Linux comes free of invasive telemetry and offers incredible transparency because of its open source nature. With that being said, today we're taking a look at a project that aims to at least in part address some of the security concerns of traditional Linux distributions by significantly hardening existing components and systems. Curious to learn more? Click the link to watch the full video.